One of the sort of happy accidents, I guess, of being in somewhere as busy as New York and struggling to get around a little bit and finding it quite disorientating and a little bit scary at times, which was definitely my yesterday, that summed up my yesterday, is it's making me understand my dad's condition a lot more. My dad is partially sighted, and with it being one of those sort of invisible conditions, a lot of the time we forget that he has it, and we just, you know, stride around London with him or what have you, and forget that actually it can be really disorientating. And I'm not saying that what I have is anything like that, but with me just being able to look straight down, I'm kind of lacking that ability to look from side to side and upwards and things like that. And you actually realise how important that is in just getting around. And you know, suddenly there'll be something that's kind of close-ish to me in my peripherals, and I dodge, I like kind of jump out of the way because it feels like it's a lot closer than it actually is, and it's incredibly disorientating and quite scary. And then I feel like an idiot because I've just jumped and something's not that close to me. My spatial awareness is terrible. I've walked into lampposts, I've done all sorts. And so, I mean, yesterday I basically sort of left the hotel and I went to get some provisions because it's always nice to have like snacks for the hotel room, I think, and like water and stuff. And there was a Whole Foods nearby and I love a Whole Foods, so I popped down there and got some stuff. And then when I was coming back, I tried to cross the road, but it was really, really busy. And I think I crossed when it was free, but then by the time we'd kind of made my shaky way across, it was getting busier and I could hear the traffic coming, but I couldn't see it, and it was really scary. And then I kind of went really, really shaky, and I was going to go and sit in the park, but I just got too shaky and too scared. So I sort of came back to my hotel and I had my lunch and stuff like that, and I just felt like I'd kind of lost the battle against it. But it's really intimidating to go somewhere that's new and really busy and not be able to see. And I just salute anyone who is blind, partially sighted, for just going out there and doing stuff, because God knows how you do it without feeling frightened. And if you do feel frightened, well done for carrying on doing it, because I wimped out, you know, I came back here. But today I'm going to see my friends who live over here, and that'll be nice because then it's sort of a day of doing stuff, but with people that know that I can't really see very well and that I'm struggling, and that will be able to help me a little bit. So it's kind of the soft version of an excursion, but really looking forward to seeing them. But yeah, so a big salute to anyone that's dealing with sort of eye conditions or anything that makes it very hard for them to see, because if you're still going out and doing stuff, I don't know how you're doing it. I don't know how you're doing it, because it makes me not want to. It makes me kind of feel like I'm going to get squashed. Or I guess you kind of have coping mechanisms and you get used to it over time and you learn things. I guess that's how you deal with it. But yeah, just a lot of extra respect now for my dad, who is an awesome, amazing person who has done so much since he was diagnosed and does more now than he ever did before, I think. But just a big salute to him forever going outdoors and probably going outdoors that first time and then continuing to go outdoors and do things where it's scary and walk around London with us. And thanks, Dad.